Hello and welcome to this next video on mobile repairing. In this video, we will learn something very different. We are not going to be doing any mobile repairing here, but we are going to try and understand how we can repair one of the most important tools that we use in mobile repairing. As you can see in front of you, we have a micro soldering iron that's kept in front of you. Micro soldering iron is something that we use to solder components onto the PCB of a mobile phone, or sometimes to remove these components from the PCB of a mobile phone. Many a times, the soldering iron can also have problems, and this will disrupt your mobile repairing work. So instead of taking the soldering iron to someone external to repair it, we can ourselves repair the micro soldering iron. It's a very simple tool, and some of the common mistakes or problems that come in a micro soldering iron can be rectified by yourself. Now, there are many types of soldering irons. The one that you see in front of you, the yellow color one, is used for soldering large components. This is not something that can be used on a mobile PCB, but something that can be used on large components which are related to mobile repairing or even related to electrical or other electronic components. However, while we are working on mobile repairing, we will be using the micro soldering iron. The micro soldering iron is called so because the soldering tip of a micro soldering iron is very minute or very sharp and can actually be very easily used on mobile PCBs to place minute components onto the PCB. First of all, let's understand the parts of the micro soldering iron. Now, this works on a DC voltage, and this is the soldering iron tip. It needs to be placed in the holder here. This needs to be connected to the main power. You have a plug point there, connect it. Once you switch it on, you will be able to see the indicator light signifying that the power supply is on. You can also use the switch provided on the micro soldering iron to turn it on and off when required. And once the power is switched on, you can adjust the voltage of electricity that is passed on to the micro soldering iron tip. Using the voltage, you can determine how much heat you want to pass on or transfer to the micro soldering iron. If you want it to be a little more hotter, you can turn up the voltage. Or if you want to reduce the heat, you can reduce the voltage using this knob. Now, whenever you are not using the micro soldering iron, you need to ensure that you keep it in the lowest point so that your micro soldering iron tip is not unduly heated up. This will avoid the coil from getting overheated and ensure that you extend the life of the micro soldering tip. Now, most commonly, the parts that the main parts that usually are faulty or become faulty are the iron. Now, the iron is essentially, so the main iron is one of the parts that can actually become faulty. This part typically has a coil inside. The coil heats up and transmits the heat to the tip, thereby helping you to solder. So, if this there is a problem in this particular connecting cord as well as the soldering tip, you can replace this tip very easily from the market. This tip is individually available in the shops. You can just pick it up and buy it and plug in a new tip in case if you are not able to replace this or repair this particular component. It is always recommended that you replace this particular part if there happens to be a fault in this part. You can open it and repair the coil or repair the tips, but many a times it may not lead to a successful repair, or even if you repair it, it may not last for a longer time. The coil could be loose, the coil may get disconnected again inside, which might result in the iron not getting heated up. Many a times the fitment may not be tight, and as a result, the tip could be loose. So, if the tip is loose, you will not be able to use the micro soldering iron effectively while you are soldering components on a PCB. So, you can, it's better to replace this whole part rather than try and repair this particular part. Now, in order to check whether this part is working properly or not, we will use the multimeter to check this particular part. To check the part, we keep it on the continuity testing mode as we have seen earlier, and we will check whether the multimeter is working properly. You can hear the beep. So, now we have connected it on beep continuity and you can hear the beep. So, I know that the multimeter is working properly. Now, there are two points on the one end of the micro soldering iron. You place your tips on these two points, the outer one and the inner one, and once you place the two tips of the multimeter on this, if this entire wire is intact and the connection inside is intact, you will hear a beep when you place the tips on these two aspects. If the, as you can see now, you will hear a beep. This means that the wire or the connection for this entire part is intact. So, the soldering iron and its connecting wires are intact. So, let's move on to the main station and try and understand the components inside and where problems could arise in this part. You need to open the screws on the side. We have opened some of the screws already. You can remove the rest of the screws using a screwdriver, using a proper size screwdriver. Once you open the screws and remove the top cover, you will be able to see the components inside very clearly. As you can see, the internal components are very clearly visible. Now, let's try and understand what each of these parts are. There are several parts that could become faulty. The first part is a transformer. The transformer could have problems. Transformer is primarily used to reduce the voltage of electricity that is supplied to the micro soldering iron. On one side, you have the red wire and the other side, you have black wires. There are two coils in this transformer. The transformer can become a problem. The main reason why we use a transformer in micro soldering iron is to reduce the voltage, as we said earlier, because the voltage that you get at the main plug points is usually between 220 and 230 volts. And this is very high for working in the electronic areas. You need it to be brought down to say 9 volts or 12 volts, and that is where we use this transformer. This is called a step down transformer because it brings down the voltage from 220 to 230 volts to 9 or 12 volt capacity. And this ensures that you are able to work within the range of the electronic equipment that you are trying to use. In our case, the micro soldering iron. So, the main power comes on one end and the converted power is supplied to the external output point through the black wires. The next part is the controlling circuit for altering the voltage. The knob will ensure that you are able to adjust the voltage from 0 volts to 9 volts or 12 volts depending on the capacity of the transformer, and the final power output is passed on to this point through which it is transmitted to the soldering iron. So, the output point ensures that the right amount of voltage is supplied to the micro soldering iron. Now, there could be problems in the transformer, and we can check the transformer using multimeter to check whether the transformer is connecting points are properly soldered. So, you can use the beep testing to check the continuity in the transformer. The second aspect which could have a problem is the voltage adjuster. This can also be faulty. To check this, you can very easily check the tip and find out whether it's heating up or not. If the tip is not heating up, which means the control unit for controlling voltage may not be working properly. Now, many a times, if the micro iron is not working at all or if it's in dead position, there could be three reasons why this is dead. One, the transformer could be completely dead. Second, the main lead could have been burnt, and third is the main on-off switch could have a fault. So, these are three reasons why a soldering iron set would be completely dead or unusable. So, essentially, as we just saw, the main problems that could arise in a micro soldering iron is one in the soldering iron connecting tip, which we can check using a multimeter. The second fault is when the entire multimeter, the soldering iron is dead, you need to check the transformer, the main connecting lead, or the on-off switch. These are the most common problems that could arise. The third problem is the voltage adjuster, and if the voltage adjuster is not functioning properly, the heating may not happen properly. In order to check the transformer, we use the same continuity testing, just as we do the continuity testing of the connecting point of the soldering iron tip. Similarly, we can also check the transformer also and find out if the wires are intact or if the connectivity is happening properly. Now, in order to check the transformer, you will have to look for which are the two connecting points which is connected to the transformer. Now, as you can see, these are the points where the black wires are soldered. So, if you hear the beep, as you can hear the beep, which means that the connectivity is intact. So, wherever the connecting wires are placed in the transformer, you check the connectivity at those points, you hear a beep. And it also shows the ohm reading on the screen. So, when we are checking the black wires, we are getting an ohm reading of roughly around 5 or 6 ohms. It basically means that the resistance at that point is actually 5 ohms. Because there is a coil inside, it measures the resistance also and shows you that resistance. Similarly, you can also check the red wire as well and find out whether there is any connectivity problem. As far as the voltage adjuster is concerned, you can find out by checking the tip of the soldering iron to check whether it is warming up or not, and that will tell you whether the voltage is changing depending on the requirements. And in order to check the switch, you can switch it on and off, and you will be able to check whether there is output coming from the switch. Now, if the main plug lead is faulty, you can check the main lead by placing the two probes of the multimeter on both the ends, one probe on one of the tips of the lead and the other one at the respective connecting points. You can hear the beep, which means that this line is proper and the connection is intact. Now, you move it to the next lead and check, you hear the beep, which means the second lead is also proper. So, there is no problem with the main connecting lead of the micro soldering iron. This is typically how you check a transformer, you check a micro soldering iron and find out where the mistakes are. Now, in order to understand, now let us say if the transformer has a problem and you need to replace the transformer, these transformers are available in open market. You can pick them up depending on the voltage and ampere that you require. The ranges are between 0 to 9 volt and 0 to 12 volts, and the ampere could be anywhere between 500 milliampere to 2 amperes. In this transformer, as you can see, it is very clearly indicated as 0 to 12, which means the voltage that it output voltage is between 0 to 12 volts, and this is a 2 ampere transformer. A 2 ampere transformer is a slightly higher output transformer. You may not require a 2 ampere output transformer. You can work with maybe 500 milliampere or a 750 milliampere transformer, and that should be good enough for your soldering iron to work efficiently and effectively. So, as we saw in this video, we understood how a micro soldering iron works, the different components inside a micro soldering iron, the common problems or faults that may arise in a micro soldering iron, and how to check those faults and make the necessary replacements. Each of these parts can be replaced, such as the transformer or the voltage selection indicator or the on-off switch, or even the micro soldering tip and the connector can be replaced. So, if you are able to identify the fault in the micro soldering iron, you can do the repairing yourself instead of spending money and getting it repaired from the outside. We do hope this video was useful to you. Continue learning. Good luck. Thank you.